So one of the areas where this kind of ordering process takes place in social network analysis is in measuring the centrality of different nodes. Now, we talked a little bit about centrality in a previous unit, but let me talk a little bit about some different types of centrality that you might find useful. So one that we're going to return to, and we've already kind of touched on, is this node of closeness centrality, the idea that a given node is central if it has short paths to other nodes in the network. Betweenness centrality has to do with the idea that a node is central if most of the shortest path between arbitrarily chosen pairs of nodes in the network end up having to pass through the node in question. So it's between most of the other nodes. It's kind of stuck between them. Node centrality is actually a much simpler concept. It just says that a node is central if it has lots of edges, if it's very well connected. And this is well connected in a very local sense, just in terms of the degree of the node or the number of neighbors that it has. So let's look at this one first, and then we're going to combine what we learn with other kinds of path-based metrics next.